Let's discuss how to calculate electric field and potential due to induced charges on a metal sphere. The same analysis will be helpful for us to analyze the same for different kind of metal bodies also. Like say we are given with a metal sphere which is of say radius R and it is uncharged. We can write this uncharged metal sphere, and in front of this sphere say we place a charge plus Q which is located at a distance small r from the center of this sphere, which is say the point C. And say we are required to find the electric field and electric potential at point A due to the induced charges on the surface of the sphere due to this plus Q. And we are also given that the location of point A is at a distance x from the point charge Q. Now in this situation we know well that inside a metal sphere net electric field is always zero due to static charges. So due to the point charge Q, electric field at A will be in a direction directed away from it, and the magnitude can be given as kq by x square. We can write electric field at A due to plus Q is, this electric field can be directly given as the result of a point charge kq by x square in the direction radially away from the point charge. Now we know due to the charge on this metal sphere, charges are induced on the left and right surfaces of the sphere. Here it will be minus qi and here it will be plus qi. And these are induced up to the limit when the net electric field at every interior point of the metal body should become zero. So we can say electric field at A due to induced charges can directly be given by the value which is exactly equal and opposite to the electric field which is due to the external charge, so that the net electric field at point A will become zero. So electric field at A due to induced charges must be numerically equal to kq by x square, and it is directed toward the charge plus q. That means at point A electric field due to induced charges will exist in this direction. And the magnitude of this E at A due to induced charges will be exactly equal to that of the electric field which is produced by the charge at point A. And if we wish to find out the electric potential at point A, then in the situation here we can say that as the whole metal body is equipotential, at every point the potential must be same. So we can write at point A, electric potential can be given as V at A must be equal to V at C, and we know that potential due to this charge at C will be kq by R, and due to induced charges there won't be any potential at C because all these induced charges are equidistant from C and the total induced charge is equal to zero. So V at A which is equal to V at C must be given as kq by R. Now at point A potential is kq by R, which is due to one is the external charge and other is due to induced charges. So this must be written as potential due to the charge Q, potential due to Q at A plus potential due to induced charges at A. So net potential at A is kq by R. So from this expression we can find out potential due to induced charges at point A is kq by R minus kq by x, because potential due to the external charge at point A will be given as kq by s. If we take it to the left hand side, it will be minus vqa, which is given as minus kq by x. So this will be the result of potential at point A due to the induced charge, and it is affected by the external charge plus q. And the electric field at A due to induced charges, which is again affected by the external charges, given by kq by x square. The same analysis you can use for various kind of metal objects if you wish to relate electric field and potential due to induced charges and the external electric field and potential at any point inside that metal body.